Hello, happy Monday. The Chosen here, welcome to the stream. I'm a bit miffed today, so to speak. I don't even know if that's a proper word, but I was expecting mail today. Like I mentioned on previous stream, I managed to purchase this cheap capture device so I could use real consoles, play some actual console games without using an emulator. I got everything ready. In fact, let me show you. I piled up all my NES games. I was planning on having an NES extravaganza. But no, not today. There's no mail today. There won't be any mail tomorrow either because it's Tuesday. They don't deliver mail on Tuesday for whatever reason. So I had to think of something else. It's Daggerfall time. The most biggest, the messiest, the ugliest, the buggiest role-playing game I've played, and goddamn do I love it. Let me put this away first. Hopefully this works out. I had a bit of problem putting it all together. The intro's a bit messed up because of the dustbox settings. That seems to be coming up okay though, so that's good enough. We're gonna start our new game, and you probably have played, whoever's watching this, you probably played one Elder Scrolls game. Most likely one of the newer ones. The old one is obviously a bit different. And we'll get to those eventually. Of course, we can choose our home province. All these except Imperial. Can't be Imperial. Can't be a bald-head Roman clone. So I'm gonna go with something different. Let's go Morrowind. They don't use the terms they had in the Morrowind yet, so they have the standard Dark Elf, High Elf, and the Wood Elf at this game. I'm male. I'm gonna choose. And I am gonna go with the Thief. One of my go-to classes when it comes to computer role-playing games. Well known for the adeptives of using stealth, speed, gunning steel. The steel for living. And these are the skills that we will be primarized in. Is that a word, primarized? We'll see. Yes, I'm gonna be a thief. And I'm gonna answer the questions. Oh, wait a minute. Automatically generate your background. Yeah, I'm gonna answer the questions. So it will be much more interesting. Of all disagreeable types, you have the most personal hatred for diabolic wizards. The one skill you could not work without must be lockpicking. We're gonna need lock. If we wanna be a successful thief in this, let me. I'm having a little trouble setting up this camera properly. There. That should do it. Look a little better. I hope. Anyway, we're gonna need a lot of lockpicking on this. Expertise in combat. Short, no. Yeah, let's go with short-bladed. It's a standard thing. In gratitude for services rendered, the Emperor gave you. These are interesting but slightly useless stuff. So 200 copies. As a child, your nickname was Quicksilver. That should affect our speed a bit. They are friendlier than most with, and a list of monsters. This will affect, I think it will affect the hostility of these monsters, if, should we ever encounter them. I'm gonna go with imps, since they're pretty much around early on, and they can be a bit of a hassle. Since childhood, you have saved, again, a bunch of useless items, but 100 gold piece. As much as you are able, you socialize, learn. Practice acrobatics, that's another useful skill we're gonna see. What motivates you? Fame. What god, if any, do you worship? I'm not sure if this has much effect in the game. It might affect if I try to work with these temples. I'm gonna go with none. Before you set out for Imperial City, you brought with you more gold! Yes. No. Let's go with gauntlets instead. You have the most rubble. Avoiding diseases. It's not much of a problem. I think it's easily curable if you have the right stuff. Your reputation has changed as follows. We are more in a more better position with scholars and underworld. Name thyself. I'm gonna call him the hardest part of the game. Let's go with the chosen. Simple answer. Choose my face or thy face. A lot of dark elves here. Not a lot of good options. That's always a problem that I have with Elder Scrolls games. There never seems to be the right head or right hair. Even when you install hundreds of mods, I'm never satisfied with the available heads and hairs. Let's go with the white one. Now here's our stat reroll. If we want, we could reroll everything as long as we want to. But I could reroll if I want a specific stat, but I don't really have any preferences. Let's go with more agility. No, let's not. Let's speed it up so we're faster. And strength is useful. There, plus one on damage. Now skills, we got primary, major, and minor. And there's also the rest of the skills, which we can raise if we want, but they're on much lower than minor skills. Short blade, since we're gonna do, we will be doing a lot of combat. Lockpick, since if we're gonna steal, we're gonna need the lockpicking. Highly critical skill. For minor, let's put a couple points on running and rest on dodging. Player reflexes determine the overall speed of the game. Basically a difficulty meter, so I'm gonna go average. This pretty much only affects on combat, though. And here if we want to change anything or restart the thing, but let's not. I'm fiddling with the settings to see if we can get this cutscene to run properly.
400 years after Tiberceptor's reign,
and this is
the beginning
spot for me to do some audio checking.
The circle will close at the Empire of Cambria.
If this sounds bright,
the
unworthy
heirs of the Septim Dynasty have allowed the bonds of the Empire to weaken and crack. Uriel Septim, the seventh, cannot repair what his ancestors ignored. Provinces fight among themselves like neglected children, drunk with rebellion, and one indomitable power hides itself, but not forever.
So I hope you all got that. I didn't, but it doesn't matter, it's just filler. Now this is the most important part.
Excuse the gloom, but none may know of this meeting. The nature of my trouble is darker still. Over a year ago, King Lysandus of Daggerfall died honorably on the field of battle.
Wait a minute, that's not Patrick Stewart.
He was as loyal a subject, ally, and friend as you are.
How nice of you.
I did grieve for him. But his spirit does not rest. With a spectral army, he haunts his former kingdom, crying for revenge. I do not know why a good and loyal man would be so cursed. Perhaps you can find the answer and close the marble jaws of oblivion, bringing peace to his soul. I ask this as your emperor and as your friend. I have one lesser request. Several years ago, I wrote a letter to the Queen of Daggerfall, It never arrived. The letter was of a sentimental and personal nature. If you find and destroy that letter, I will be grateful. Now, my champion, rest well this night. For tomorrow you sail for the kingdom of Daggerfall.
And so our grand adventure begins. You wake and look around the room. Some hours ago you were in a boat en route to Daggerfall, when a storm of supernatural strength boiled over the Iliac Bay like a malefic creature. Your boat was destroyed, but you managed to swim through the churning water to a promontory rock. There you found a cave and escaped the fury of the storm. You had only just lit a small fire when a mudslide sealed you within. Your fear of being buried alive calmed when you saw a corridor leading out of the cavern. Perhaps there is a way out of this cave after all. Once free of the cave, you can begin the Emperor's quest. No tutorials. I know how to do this. So, first of all, I'm gonna put up the music and sound a bit more. Bit less, that is. There. Okay, let me make another sound check. It's not sounding good enough. Let me go to the Streamlabs settings. Well, for whatever reason, the microphone volume is not as high as it was on other streams. I don't know why. Hold on, maybe the connection seems okay. Maybe I just need to up the volume a bit. You there on the background, shut up. Here you go. Alright, I'm gonna put up the cycles back up on Dustbox. And I'm gonna make another sound check. Let's see how this works out. Okay, seems to be much better. If you guys watching this, let me know if the sound's okay. If you can hear me, if you can hear the game at all. I should actually put it on. Just in time to hear some random sound effects. So, Daggerfall! Let's get down to the meat and potatoes. And I have to do a little bit of this. Okay, this one's better. Ready weapon, let's make it F. That's good. So I've messed up with the settings beforehand to make it a lot more better, more easier to control. Originally, it's just, you know, using the arrow keys, which is a bit weird in the year of our Lord 2018, so this is a much more modern Elder Scrolls control style. This is us, the handsome one. We can take our shirt off, we can probably take off our pants. I don't want to, just to be sure. I can't remember if it shows anything at all. Here's our childhood gauntlets, which we can't equip. But we can use this silver dagger, which is good. We got nothing else. A log, which will include any missions that we undertake, and our history. Forbidden weaponry, blunt weapon. Thank God I didn't use axe. Can't wear chain or plate, and can't use shields. So this is a randomly generated history based on our choices. It's nothing much, it doesn't really affect the game, it's just flavor. It tells us how we met the Emperor, how we became his friend, and which is why we are now on a quest on her, on his behalf. And now we are stuck in a goddamn cave. Let's find our way out of here. There we go. Well, that. No, wait, I need to press E. I keep forgetting. And there's our first opponent, a rat! Which is shaped like a hamburger. Combat's pretty simple, just hold the right mouse button and swing or stab or swing high. Here's a pile of items. It's actually coins. So Daggerfall and Arena have, and the previous game Arena have these item piles, which might be anything. It's not like in the later games when a sword is actually a sword. Here a sword might actually be a pair of boots, 15 gold pieces, and a piece of string or something. Yeah, combat is still as riveting as it is in the future games. Random objects here and there. Yeah, just another rat burger. This one. I think there's a thief down here. Yep. Come on! Oh crap! No! Gonna save. Because I don't want to embarrass myself. I have to restart live on stream. Alright, what you got? Gold. No, I can't wear this, but I can wear this. No, it's not a short sword, but... this is good. We are building up our armor as we go. And this object here is actually gold. Here's a head. There's a lot of neat background items and this is quite gory. For Elder Scrolls game. Going down. I just realized I only have a sliver of health left. Which means even a bat could kill me if I'm not careful enough. Just gotta get lucky. I could try resting, but I feel like there's not a safe spot to rest right now. Come on! Ah! The monster is defeated. Now another opponent, another human being. It's an archer! As you can clearly see. Thankfully we can exploit the devilish AI. Nice. So do you have a broadsword, a potion of chameleon form, and more armor we can use. Good. So the thing about Daggerfall dungeons, as you will... Oh! And we're dead. And we get our burial cutscene, which plays slowly thanks to the dustbox settings. Let's try again. Kill the bat. I managed to beat the archer, but I was killed by a rat. Now he sees us. The stealth works weirdly in this game. It's kind of automatic skill. Which means that sometimes monsters won't detect you and... yeah. I don't think there's much you can do about it. You can crouch. Which I think the game might also count as sneaking. No. Dead again. Dead count too. Take you on for a ride, rat. N- Now the archer has detected me again. It still is an archer. I'm not sure, but the game might actually randomize the class of the human every time you start a new game. It doesn't matter really. Archers, thieves, they're all the same kind of enemies. Now we're more damaged. I literally have one dot of HP left, but I'm still healthy. Stab. 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 Swing. Blood splatters like ketchup. Yes. And he still has the same items. Okay. No, we can't wear the helmet. Can I rest? I can, until fully healed. And now it spawns something nearby. Yes. Well, it doesn't matter. This is actually the room I want to be in. Let's get out of here. I've played this game, oh no! Oh no. Not the opponent I want to face. He's screaming at me with stock sound effects. Hasta la vista! So I played this opening dungeon many times, and I remember exactly how you get out of this mess. But if you want, you can explore this dungeon, and I would not recommend it because it's... is a hell of a labyrinth. There's ups and downs, there's corridors, there's different kinds of rooms with no real objects. This should be our escape. It's a bat and a rat. They're teaming up. No! I was so close. Alright, once again, no. Rest. Several hours pass by as I take care of my wounds. Nice. My skills have been improved. Just like in the other Elder Scrolls games, your skills improve. They improve as long as you use them. Although in Daggerfall, you gotta rest every now and then to have your skills be raised. To have your skills be raised. That's not proper English at all. Now we should have enough health to get out of here. And eventually, once you've raised your skills enough and you've rested enough, you level up and you can raise your stats. Now come on. I think there's another creature there. Yes, there's the imp. And they're difficult because they can cast spells. Yeah. Got lucky here. Some cold pieces. And we're out of here. What was the F? This is the beautiful world of Daggerfall, ladies and gentlemen. It's winter right now, and there are sprites everywhere. Now we could walk, but it literally takes ages, so we're just gonna get on the auto map. And this is the whole game area. There's the Daggerfall region. There's the High Rock region. There's probably a little bit of Skyrim over here. We are in here right now. In fact, this is our exact location. Every single dot you see on here is a place you can visit. There's dungeons, there's temples, small homes and towns. And depending on the color, the more brighter it is, the more bigger it is. And the actual Daggerfall city is right over here. We're not gonna go there yet. We're gonna look around a bit more. I'm out over there, so let's go here. Chesterwark. We can affect our travel if we approach recklessly. It means that we'll get there faster, but most likely we'll arrive at night, which might cause other problems, especially if the city has walls. Then we can't get in, obviously climb over it. We have arrived around 6 o'clock. In the eyes of the law of Daggerfall, you are a common citizen. That status will affect depending on if we get caught on doing illegal stuff. So this is the ye old Elder Scrolls. This is your dad's Elder Scrolls. Look at this. Man. There's random NPCs walking around. They're all random. How can I help you, stranger? The NPCs, they don't really serve any importance at all. Other than to dish out locations of various services. And you can ask them about work. And maybe rumors, depending on situations. Let's go find a pawn shop. Tell me where the pawn shop is. Oh, well, this actually means that one of my skills has failed. Let's see, where is it? Yeah, streetwise. When talking to the NPCs, there are several different kinds of NPCs. And they give you information depending on if you succeed in your skill. I think. I'm not exactly sure. This might be just guesswork. But streetwise works when talking to the people on the streets. And then there's the... Where is it? Etiquette. Which works when talking to nobles. I'm just gonna talk to another guy. It's not much of a deal. I'll try to be blunt. Where's the Lord Utyviris? Where's this guy's antiques? Oh! No need to be rude about it. This is weird. I could just find it myself, but this is the thing. This is how huge this city is. Green places are taverns. Orange things are shops, and these are guilds. It could be any one of this, any one of these, and let's go to a nearby spot. This building here is a guild. If you look at it, we'll learn that it's a Knights of the Dragon. Now it's marked to our map, but there's literally no distinct features to distinguish it from other guilds. Well, temples do actually look a bit different, but that's about it. And that's a tavern called Unfortunate Muskrat. And there's two other taverns nearby. And they are as identical as it is. The Gold Porcupine. Hey. I'm looking for pawn shop. Southwest of where you're standing. Alright. That narrows it down. That's a normal residence. I'm looking around and I'm pressing the E. There it is. Opens at 9, so we gotta wait a bit. We gotta loiter. If we try to sleep, we'll get accosted by guards. For loitering. Well, not loitering. What's the word? Vagrancy? Being a street bum. Most of the shops are pretty much the same on the inside. But at least the actual merchandise, it varies. It's all randomly generated. Here just a bunch of books. But we can check each shelf to get another set of items. And yes, we can try stealing, but I'm not gonna do that yet. What's that? Just a parchment. There's a painting. A lot of these items are basically just junk. And the only purpose for it is to steal or loot and then sell them to, well, pawn shops and the like. I can talk to the merchant and sell my stuff. That's a nice amount of money. And now it uses our merchant skill, and yeah, usually we get a very low price for all the stuff we sell. I'm gonna take it anyway. Like, I have a choice. We can also talk to these guys, just like the other NPCs, and probably uses another skill to get information out of him. Say, do you have any news? Have you heard any news? A vagrancy law. You can't sleep in the streets. Well, thank you. Thank you for confirming my thoughts. You have to get a room at an inn. Exactly. We can look around the shop as well, but there's usually nothing interesting here. Oh, there's a guy. He just lives here. Hey, have you heard of any news? Corellia Stormwarren was overthrown. Long live Yushu Sadabi, newly made Lord of Mirkwasa. This kind of stuff happens. People get killed, they die, get overthrown, and then there's a new ruler on some place. It doesn't affect anything. I think the original idea was that there would be more intrigue politics system in this game, but yeah, they have to cut down some stuff to get this out. That's a holy dagger. It's not actual weapon, it's another decoration. Actually, let's see. I think there's upstairs. There's not a... I was hoping there would be a door to balcony so we could try stealing something and then escape through the balcony. Stealing is tough. If I try to steal something and I fail, I think it's using my stealth skills. It might use pickpocket. So, anyway, if I fail and get caught, I don't get anything, and the guards spawn right at the entrance. And if they hit me, if they even hit me, then they know that I'm a villain. And everyone hates me around Daggerfall. So, what to do next? And this is the beauty of the game. I could follow the main quest, which actually hasn't started yet. But otherwise, I have all the freedom of this large digital world. Let's try the basics. Where can I find some work? There's a guy at the Unfortunate Muskrat. And lucky for us, we actually passed that by. Let's go there. That's how you get work. If you don't go to the guilds and temples and the like, you just ask around and they tell you that there's guy X on a place Y that has a work. And again, it's all randomly generated. Oh, that's someone's bedroom. There we go. And again, bunch of random NPCs here. With all random information, but this is the guy we want to speak to. Or is it? Maybe it's one of the guests. Little boy? No, wait, it's gotta be the woman. No, it's not. Oh. Well, we can have a drink. Give me a glass of wine. It raises our meters a little bit, that's all. I'm looking for work. Lady Dunnector's bookstall. Alright. So I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. I have no explanation. So he said a bookstore. This one. Northwest. Sometimes if I ask enough or if I get lucky, they'll actually mark the location on my map. An armory. White dog. And there's actual dog. Can't interact with it, it's just a sprite. And it just barked at me. Odd armor, mage's guild. Guilds actually offer specific kinds of quests compared to more random quests you can find on, well, business premises. Bargain arms maker. You can join any guild, technically, as long as you fulfill the requirements. So, even thieves can become members of the mage's guild if they can cast high enough spells. Did we miss the store? Let's ask. Bookstore. Northwest. Okay. Gotta keep going. Actually, one of the things we have to get early on is a horse. So we can walk faster. That's probably it. Now it's Adventurers Incunabula. What is that? It's a bookstore. Not the one we're looking for. So it's the one in the corner. Bingo. Bookstores are interesting. They sell books. Which is really not that useful, since you can go to... If you want to read a book in this game, you can go to the library. And yeah, that's free. I heard you got a job. Someone has been spreading rumors that I need help. I don't need any help in anything. Ah, that happens. Actually, let's try talking again if... Oh. Random sound effects. And the clock is that much, but it's actually... Most of the sound effects are random. They might depend on your location. What's going on with his face? That's weird. Never noticed that. So, work. King's Goat. Bannon Badger. I'm just gonna try my luck. Sometimes if you go to the store and talk to the person, he might actually have a job for you, even if you haven't asked around. Like this place. You have another bookstore. Ah, see? I talk to him and I hear bells again. It's an Elder Scrolls game. This game was notoriously bugged when it came out. So, having a sound effect related to a bookstore salesman is probably another bug. Baden Dungeon. Thank you. Yeah, they don't have any work for me. Actually, I'm tired of walking around. Maybe I should try buying that horse. General stores have a horse. South, southeast, east. You can buy a horse and you can also buy a cart. So that, just so that you can haul around more stuff. Because this, all the loot, all the gold pieces will weigh you down. The Rusty Rascal. Palace. Sometimes nobility, nobles might have a special kind of assignments for me. But I don't doubt that. I don't have much of skill. I don't have much of reputation yet. Might have actually passed that. Dr. Edubebebes. There we go. Right, the horse on the shelf. Let's see if he keeps... Oh! Yeah. We need a lot more than we can bargain for. I'm gonna save, actually. I'm gonna try my luck and steal a horse. First, do you have a job for me? No. Then I'm gonna take your horse. No!
Hold! 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 Hold!
Okay, if I make a dash through there...
Hold! 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 Hold!
No!
Hold! Hold!
Now this way should be free. And I made it! Got away scot-free. I could join in the Thieves Guild, but I need to perform some things before I can get in there. Namely, just steal stuff. And getting into someone's apartment house is a tricky thing. Okay, it's not that tricky. So yeah, there's... Oh! Sorry! Well, now this Twitch got way too hot. Yeah, that's a weird thing with this... with Daggerfall. There's a lot of... Well, not a lot of, but there's random nudity. If you barge in on people's houses or in the tavern rooms, well, I guess it makes sense. But you know, for a game as huge as this is in the year 1996, it is notable. Actually, if I want work, I might as well check with the Fighters Guild. I can take assignments from guilds, but I don't necessarily have to join. What you got for me, pal? Oh! First the people on the streets, now the people in the guilds. This guy likes me. I'm Dundane Gyrefield. The Fighters Guild doesn't hand out charity work. If it weren't short on fighters right now, I'd have sent you away. I do need a fighter to chase up some barbarians that are running wild. Alright. Yeah, sure. The Woodham Residence. Run out the barbarians by this time tomorrow and you'll be okay. Okay. He didn't mention anything about the reward, but... Sure, I'll take it. Sounds easy enough. Now we just have to find the residence, and we do it the same way as the other places. Ah, thank you. They actually marked it in our map. I think that's it. It's overlapping with the antique store. And now we just jog in there. While we are on our way, might as well talk a bit more about the Daggerfall. A lot of this stuff you see here, the towns, the cities, Even the dungeons, they are not all built by programmers and such. They are all computer generated. And by that, I don't mean they randomly generated each time. They made an algorithm, they made specific parts in the coding, and then they had computer build everything. With the results, you have impressively huge places that feel like they might be actual cities and dungeons and like. But as a downside, there's not much uniqueness there. All the details the same. There might be some variation depending on where you are. But yeah, not much differences here. There's the Bootham residence. Again, for example, this building, it could be any one of these buildings, but the computer just picked this one. There's no real Woodham residence. Oh, shh! Right in the action. Hold on, Milk Maiden. I'll save you. Ah, oh, he got me there. I just have to keep strafing around him so he can't hit me. Wait, it's actually her. Barbarian is dead. Hopefully you're happy now, lady. I'm gonna loot you. Take your armor. I'm gonna take all this stuff and sell it to the pawn shop. Am I your hero now? Yeah, she's rude, just like everyone else. Let's just go away. There's a pig nearby, making noises. Yes, indeed, I'm playing Daggerfall. I've had much experience with Daggerfall ever since I had a friend burn it for me on a CD back in 2005, I think, and I played it so much. In fact, this is probably the first ever game that I played 24 hours and plus. I played it for a whole day. I didn't sleep. I did eat stuff. Took some lunch break. But yeah, it's totally addictive. All thanks to the randomization. Again, didn't really succeed in haggling, but does this guy have a job for me? No. He ignores me. Ooh, what's that? Chain gauntlet. Actually, we can't use chain material. Yeah, there's nothing else. Quite a small shop. But yeah, blacksmiths also offer blacksmiths' armors. They offer repairs because your items will get damaged, especially armor. But doesn't really matter because you'll find a lot of armor pieces in this game. Let's head back to the fighter's guild and hopefully get our reward. Sometimes you don't get a reward, you just get some reputation. It's a random clothing store. This is the library. Jewelry, arms maker. There it is. Behind these stores. At least the guilds are shaped differently. You can easily spot a fighter's guild. I have succeeded in my job. Well, that was a waste of time. Or at least I did get some money out of the barbarian armor, but that was pretty much just a job that pays in experience. Do I have enough money right now to get the horse? Not nearly enough. Work. I was at the unfortunate muskrat. Precious stones. I think we passed that. Yes. The jewelry maker has a work for us. Let's see what kind of a hideously bugged quest it will randomly generate for us. I see he's got a lady servant here. No? Will you? Oh, this. My name is Barbolda Buckingfield. I have a mission that requires utmost stealth and secrecy. The risk is minimal and it will pay 147 gold pieces. Sure! I'm a stealth guy, I can do it. Go to the White Sword in Bengate Dairy. Lodge there is a courier bearing a letter. Take it and leave this false one in its place. Do not disturb any of his belongings. Alright! Easy enough. Let me check my logbook to see what the place was again. Bengate Dairy. Alright. So we go over on auto map. We find Bengate. It's over there. No, wait. That's just Bengate. Over there. Yeah, let's walk cautiously. We have all the time in the world. It was like 35 days or something. Trip cost. We can camp out if we want to save some money. But this also helps us rest during our travel, so we can get our life back. Alright. And it also raises our skills, just like resting does. This is a small town, so this should be an easy job. Not a lot of going on around here. Tavern looks like any other. However, for you, the place where stealth counts for more than strength. Now find out where the courier has left the letter. Gonna save just in case. So we gotta find something that looks like a letter. Excuse me, lady. Sorry. At least when you're doing quests like these, the letter actually looks like a letter. Or when a bottle of poison is a bottle of poison. Oh, that was an exit. That's also an exit, I think. Just probably in this room. Don't mind me. It's not in here. It's not in that crate. There might be stuff in that crate, but it counts as stealing. An exit. Let me restore. Now the woman's not here. All part of the random generalization. Randomization. That's the actual word. Well, you know you're playing an Elder Scrolls game when things aren't working as they should be. Maybe it is in the box after all. Nope, can't interact with the box. There is no other rooms in this place. There's no upstairs. No, wait! I missed it. Aha! I'm gonna crawl, just in case. To feel more sneaky. There it is. We take the leather. Oh, we leveled up. Let's put some points in endurance. Just for fun. Yeah, sometimes the game doesn't notify that you level up. You have to actually see it yourself. Now the letter. Ah, crap, which one it is? Cast my bolt. Ah, crap. Have to reload the game. All right, let's make sure. I've decided to cast my boat for kill pirates of Fort Treasurer. Theory Star Mastercraft. Okay. Just have to leave the letter. Yes. As the letter full of lies leaves your finger, you know that your quest is half done. There, and now we can't mess with the other stuff. Well, that completes that quest. Maybe we can buy a horse. Let's give it a try. Now we just gotta get back to the town and get our money for the quest. Yes! Wait, what? Ah, we're just missing a few pieces. Ah, damn it, and such a good deal for a horse. I'm gonna make a decision. I'm gonna sell some of my armor. And he doesn't want to buy any of that. Oh, not successful. But I did manage to get past the guards. Well, let's head back to wherever we was. Gotta check the logbook. Chest of Work, that's the place. A courier steps up to you, gives you a letter in hand. I was told to give you this letter to someone within your description. That's the main quest knocking. I heard about the accident at sea and feared the worst. Now that I've heard you're alive and well, I would like the opportunity to meet you and discuss our beloved Emperor's mission. For the purpose of our meeting, I will take a room at Inn, the Pig and Jug in Harcourt Hall, for a month. So we can, we still have time, we'll do this later. If we don't, and we allow the month to pass, then the main quest is over. And it technically makes the game unbeatable. But that doesn't stop us from playing. We can still continue on. Do random quests if we want to. I guess that's nice. That there's so much freedom in this game. That doesn't even care. Chester Pork. And now we got a little bit of faster traveling time now that we have horse. No, wait. We don't have a horse. What am I saying? The mood is a little bit different right now. There's some guards. If I'd actually go on a murder spree and try to kill the people, kill some people, then the guards would try to stop me. Yeah, Morrowind is a fun game too. I really like it. I played that a lot. I don't know which one I played more, this or Morrowind. I should get around playing some more of that. Not a big fan of Oblivion though. I have it, but I played it only like a couple of minutes. Then I gave up. It wasn't just clicking for me at the moment. I do recommend Skyrim. I always recommend Skyrim. This, Morrowind and Skyrim, definitely worth trying out. Well done. Here is your reward. Never mention this affair to anyone. Our job is done. Do you have any other work? Yes. Dangerous mission. I cannot tell you more other than say that it's worth 252. Alright, tell me. Go to the Crimson Griffin. There you will find my master. Oh, interesting. Crimson Griffin. Excuse me, I'm trying to find a tavern. It's called the Crimson Griffin. Thank you. Actually, no, that's the White Guard. The Crimson Griffin, you say? There it is. So, it's one of these. One of these is the master. Know me for who I really am. I'm your mortal enemy, Uthastur Wickwing. I have a special fate in store for you. Oh crap! No! I will defeat you, I don't know how you escape from Asmeo sent us then, the Chosen. I won't do you much good though. Prepare to die! What? What the hell? What the hell? Surrounded by rats! Utterly dazed and confused. There's dogs! Something growling. Oh god, it's coming! It's coming at me! Oh shit, it's a werewolf! This is not good! Oh god, oh dear! Oh god, oh man! Okay. Let's reassess the situation. We got to meet this guy's master. He didn't tell any more details. We go. He's apparently our mortal enemy. He fights us. And now he's teleported us to here. I'm gonna have to check the logbook. Is this actually how it's supposed to go? Okay, it is supposed to happen like this, but it is glitching out. They blanked the Chosen's house. This is not my house. This is not my beautiful house. This is not my beautiful wife. And to make matters worse, there are werewolves. I can fight a werewolf, but I would not fight a werewolf at this moment. So our best choice now is to find the exit. And this is... Oh shh! Things are getting even worse. That is a goddamn scorpion! I'm out, Ski. I just been hit with a massive bad luck and I've been spawned in a dungeon with much too difficult enemies. As I was about to say, I'm not gonna pick that up. There's a scorpion behind the door. Ah, finally something I can handle. A bat. So here's the thing with Daggerfall's dungeons. They're easily the worst part of the game. As with the towns and cities, they are computer generated, meaning computer built them all according to the code. There's specific building parts it uses, and you can combine part X with part A, B, and C, for example. And then it's all randomization. It's not different every time, it's different. It's, again, computer generated. It means that. It just means that computer did it before they shipped the game. And that means all these dungeons are goddamn massive labyrinths of corridors, rooms, hidden paths. They make no sense whatsoever. I mean, they're huge, they're impressively huge, but there is no sense made to this. That's what always bugs me when people talk about Skyrim or Morrowind or even Oblivion. They always compare the dungeons and they say they dumped it down in Skyrim. Just look at the sizes of these dungeons, which is not true at all. I'd rather play any of Skyrim's dungeons than be stuck here in this hellhole. Oh god. It's making cat noises. I know that I don't have to go there anymore. I think that just leads to a dead end. But there's that one locked door with the scorpion behind it. Oh, it's you again. Just gonna run past you. Oh, shh! Not. No, no. Ugh. Right into the arms of a centaur. So we're back where we left off. I'm just gonna take this real quickly and... There he comes. Watch out, boys. He'll chew you up. A real man-eater. There's a centaur. Maybe here? Just more corridors and passageways. More dead ends. Another one! Oh no! Oh man. Oh man. I may have put myself in a near impossible situation. Oh. As you can see, it's all the loot stacks are all randomized. Now there's a book. Random objects. Managed to close the door behind me. Alright. We're back on a track. No werewolves, no scorpions, no centaurs. See, now it's a different kind of corridor. It makes no sense. I'm not even sure if I'm closer or farther from the exit. Oh god. now there's water. And you can hear the bees down there. This just keeps getting better and better. Random room. This feels... Yes! There's a hidden ball here. Oh no! Oh no! Cross the bridge! Gotta escape! I just hope the exit is not underwater. It might happen. Because all the randomization. No. Forget it. No, nuts. Yes. Scorpions are difficult enemies to deal with. If they manage to hit you, there's a good chance that you get paralyzed. And that makes you a easy pickings for them. Ah! If we fail to unlock the door, we can just hit it. There's nothing here. Not even hidden doors. There's another scorpion nearby. I think that's a centaur. Yes. It hasn't spotted us. Oh, it has spotted us. That's how stealth works. No. Ah, shit. Oh, crap. There's three centaurs running behind me. No. And we're back here. Let's take a look at the map. As you can see, let's put it on 3D. So yeah, can you tell any details? Can you pick up any rooms that we were in? No. You've got to be good at reading this map, because the more you explore, the more harder it is to find places that you haven't explored. Please don't be anything. Ah, no. 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 Hit a door. I'm being saved. Die, bat. No. Oh. Oh. Wow. Oh dear, oh dear. Wow, you know what, guys? I'm gonna take a short break. I'll be right back with Daggerfall. Don't go anywhere. And we're back. Thank you all for waiting. I have to take a bathroom break and think about the situation, and I'm gonna make an executive decision to restart the game. Yep, unfortunately I'm gonna have to do it. I've put myself in a near impossible situation, and I don't want to spend the rest of the stream running around trying to find the exit. So we're gonna make another dark elf thief. Wizards, lockpicking, short-bladed weapons, gold pieces, quicksilver, imps, the gold pieces, acrobatics, fame, none, gold pieces, avoiding diseases. Name thyself. Choose the dark elf with white hair. Nah, that seems good enough. Put some money on points on perception. Maybe that will help get some more information and some on speed. All on short blade. All on lockpicking. And on dodging. And here we go again. Now watch me speedrun this thing. Again, we get the same stuff as before. Or I guess it's because of what we chose. And again, this dungeon is just like the other dungeons. It's huge. It's confusing, but at least I've played this so much so that I know where the exits are. So I can just beeline straight to the exit. Ooh, that's an interesting piece of clothing. I'm gonna put on the shirt. You can get different clothes in this game. It doesn't affect at all. At least I think it doesn't. If it does affect, it's not clear. The only reason it is there is that you can make your paper doll look pretty. Die, monster! I'm in a hurry. Gotta get out of here. This enemy is still an archer. Yes. When it comes to dungeon enemies, at least in the other dungeons, I think how it works is that there's different groups of enemies, and when you enter the dungeon, it picks up a specific group, which will then spawn everywhere around it. And in my case, it picked scorpions, centaurs, and werewolves. Which, considering I was still at level 2, it's pretty much... it's a very, very, very bad condition. This dungeon doesn't do that. There are specific enemies in this dungeon. The rat burger. And our final obstacle. Rat, the bat, and the imp. Gonna save. Come on, where are you? Yeah. And this is why we save. Oh. For whatever reason, the volumes just got very loud. Come on, eat it! You're just a rat! Come on! Oh. I could just avoid it, but I also want to kill it. Just in case it carries enough loot. It's hard to dodge him, especially since he's casting spells. Come on! I can feel it, he's dying. There we go. No treasure. Fine. I'll take it. Whew. Time to head to... Tunmat. That sounds good. This one's a lot smaller town. Doesn't have any walls. Unlike Chesterwick. Maybe the people like me here. Not a lot going around here. Vintage supply store. Ah, so she has heard about the job, but she doesn't know where the store is. I'm willing to bet it's one of these two. In fact, it's right around the corner. What's with the music? It keeps going back up. So I heard you got a job for me. What is it? It appears that one of my former associates, in the effort to make my life more hellish, has passed some counterfeit gold bricks. Our place must retrieve those gold bricks before they're discovered. Okay. Easy job. I can steal stuff. We gotta go to Midbury. Oh no. Castle Necromogan. That's another dungeon. We walked right into another dungeon quest. Fine, we'll do it. We'll go to Midbury first, I think. Actually, I should probably write this all down. So I don't have to check my logbook every second. Midbury. Bank. Holding wall at the palace. And the Woodstone residence. And that's also in Midbury. That's good. Yeah, may Oblivion help me. Can I steal your horse? I really could use a horse.
Oh! Oh!
No?
Oh! 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 Oh!
Alright, we're off to Midbury. So it's in a bank and this random person's house. Of course, there's two banks of Daggerfall. So we have to check both banks. You see, kids, this is what happens when you let the computer generate your missions. You know, after this, I think I'm gonna play some Skyrim afterwards to get this taste out of my mouth. I mean, it's not bad game. It's just that it does so many things wrong. And people seem to like it. People seem to think this game is, in design, is much better than the other, than the future Elder Scrolls games. Where's the bank? Tell me. Oh, now there's three banks. What the hell? Now there's two banks again. What is with this game? One of these orange blobs. Is that it? No, it's a market. No, wait, west, not east. Arsenal. Looking for the bank. Thank you. So it's one of these, I think. That's an interesting walking noise he's making. There it is, that's the bank. It's closed. We're gonna loiter, we have to loiter around a bit. 2 hours. Hopefully it's the right bank. At least we leveled up. I'm gonna put on... Let's round up our speed and put some more personality. Is that personality? Yes. Hopefully this is the right bank and not the wrong. And hopefully not the right bank is not the ghost bank. Which may or may not appear in the dialogue. Of course, there's nothing preventing me from just abandoning this quest. But that will hurt my reputation a bit. Not that I have any reputation to begin with, but... Yeah, it's the wrong bank. It's the wrong goddamn bank. And they sell books in banks. Actually, banks are just a way to get rid of some of the excessive money. Oh. It's right about next door. Come on, gold bar. Where are you? There it is. If I can just... Got it. The next place was the Woodston residence. At around here as well. Looking for Woodston residence. Alright, southwest. It's one of these nondescriptive buildings. Let's ask again. southwest. Thank you. Just what I wanted. Alright. It's near the wall. A library. There it is. And thankfully we can just waltz in. And let's find that gold bar. There's a random store shelf on here. There's the owner of this house. Thankfully she ignores us. Ah, it's in the attic. Let's see, how do I use the ladders again? Ah, never mind. I think it's time to demonstrate the climbing of this game. To climb, you just gotta run up against the wall. Just like that. Oh, crap! There's people here. Oh, crap! They got bows. And they're gone. Fortunately, there is no gold bars here. And I think those enemies just fell through the floor. Another sign of... Finally found it. Another sign of miracle programming of Daggerfall. Two bars. Two to go. That's in Alding Wall. At the palace. At least the music's decent. Where's the palace? Northeast, okay. That's northeast. The palace is thankfully one of the most easily noticeable buildings. That's not it, that's just a random garden. I think that might actually be a catacomb. We take a look at the map. That's the palace, right over there. We really have to get the horse. The horse is one of our main priorities. But to get the horse, we gotta have some money. There you are. Hopefully we can walk right in. Yes, we can. And there's our gold bar. Let's actually try talking to this guy. Buckingston, another random NPC, but he's the, I don't know what's the term, mayor, maybe a count, but he rules his place. But it doesn't matter what he does, he's still a random NPC, but this one, he might have a job for us. And this guy apparently works for him. Well, I put it up long enough. Now we gotta go to the dungeon. I can actually take it out, and it's the orange spot. The red spots are just random crypts and graves. Castle Necromorgan. Now you may wonder, where is that dungeon entrance in this wasteland? It's here. This is the dungeon. How foreboding. Thankfully, despite the fact that these dungeons are randomly, well, not again, not randomly, computer generated, they are still the same dungeons on every playthrough, no matter what. So if you can, you know, use a walkthrough or a map, you can, if one exists. However, no matter what the quest is, the actual location of the gold bar is probably randomized. You might have a general idea, like sometimes the thing you're looking for is the oh no, it's a spider. I think I can take it on. Now, what did you do to me? Is this poison? So yeah, like I was saying, usually the things you're looking for in the dungeons, they are hiding behind a secret door. Of course, there's plenty of secret doors and rooms in the dungeons, so good luck. Whatever that spider did me, it passed away. Oh man. No, not my first time. I played Daggerfall plenty of times. Nothing in here. Come on. Thankfully, so far it's just bats and spiders. I'm stuck. Now I'm free. Now where that one gold bar might be. Another thing in the dungeon is that you go around here, you collect all kinds of loot. And whatever it is, it's probably much more worth than what the actual quest, the actual prize money you'd be promised for the quest is. Ah, no. Three spiders. I can take them on. No? Oh! This is a fine pickle. He's chewing me up. I think this is about it. Yes, I do know about the smaller user interface. Actually, let's turn it on. There. I don't actually like this one since I like to push the buttons. But it does, it probably looks much better on the stream. Let's go this way. Can I reach it? Oh! I'm actually stuck now. Hold on, I'm free. Ah, great. I think that's a skeleton shouting obscenities at me. Die. Dancing the waltz of death. I really need to get a much better weapon. This is like... Yeah, this is it. I might as well load the game. Up. And it's still... I still had to get that animation. Nice. Okay, where was that? No, that's the water. Let's see if I can jump over it. Yep! Nice. Just more corridors. Oh yeah, I could have chosen the ebony dagger at the beginning, of course. But for now, we'll just have to make do with the silver dagger. Come on. Do you have any gold bars in here? Well, there is gold, I think. Ooh, well, just some junk. That's another pit. Yeah, I could have done an OP build. I'm running a thief right now, but I could have just made my own character class, have a longsword with him or something. Much more useful, but then again, I do prefer to play fair, and I do like challenges. And just, yeah, brilliant. Let me check. One thing this map's useful is detecting hidden doors. So I don't have to crawl across the wall and find out myself. Over and under and past the giant tree trunks, I guess. Another bloody spider. And it got me. I think this is it. Yeah, let's reload. Ugh, goddamn dungeon quests. I'm thinking I might as well abandon this, but gonna give a couple more tries. At least I don't have to check those rooms again. Eat this! Yeah, there's a lot of ways you can break this game. Doing a specific builds that make you overpowered. You could absorb anything and avoid any kinds of diseases, paralyzation, whatever, but then again, I just like to have a basic game with a regular character, regular thief, and give it a shot. Now that I think about it, I don't think I've actually tried to play as a mage. Mostly just warriors and thieves. Nothing in here? Nothing, nothing at all. And I think this is just a dead end in general. Can't even find myself in the map. Yeah. Let's head down and find another corridor. That's a dead end. I could definitely use a better weapon right now. Yep, that bat fell right into its death. Or, you know, forget the weapon. I just want to find my quest object and get out of here. I can worry about the better daggers later. Nope. More vendor junk. No, I don't want to equip that. Pliers. There's a torture chair. The scenery is nice, but you can't interact with it at all. More stuff. That sounds useful. Alright, I think I can face the spider. I don't think I can face the spider. Maybe second try. Well, now I'm stuck on it, so I just gotta swing away and hope for the best. You know, my mouse hand is literally just going. This is riveting gameplay. I don't have the Eye of Argonia right now. For the stream purposes, I made a fresh install. I'll probably have that on next time. Oh, there's another bat. Now I'm stuck. Masterfully avoided. Yeah, I guess it's less fog. I haven't actually noticed any much of a difference myself. Come on. This is not going well. I've sticked my head up a hornet's nest, or rather, spider's nest. Maybe I should abandon the quest. I mean, it's not like I'm gonna get penalized much. Just a little reputation loss. Not that I have any to begin with. Nope, not at all. I've never actually had any save game corruptions when I've been playing all my years with playing Daggerfall. Maybe it's just me, maybe I've gotten lucky. In fact, I'm more worried about other kind of stuff. Like, where the hell am I right now? I think there might be a secret door. Yeah, I can't even find myself on this map anymore. There you are. Oh. Oh dear. I think you can open that from somewhere. Maybe up there. Yeah, these dungeons are just way too much. I never understood people who love these dungeons and keep comparing them to the, like, dungeons in Skyrim. Saying that these are better. These are just mess. Just a mess. A big pile of computer-generated mess. I mean, it's even worse if you're so deep in this dungeon that you're even start forgetting where the exit is. If you don't even if you're not a spell user. No. I won't be taken down by a bat. Not after all those spiders. I'm getting tons of items though. They're much more worth than what the quest reward was. Nothing. Oh, I think I'm down for this. I'm gonna head for the exit. Forget the damn quest. I got 3 out of 4 gold bars. He's probably not gonna be happy about it, but I don't care. I just wanna get out of here. Find something easier to do. Yeah, that's the way. I think down here. And here. Here. Over the chasm. And we're home free. Thank God. No. Didn't mean to rest. Meant to fast travel. Let's go. Charton. Charton sounds good. Sell our stuff, see if we can buy a horse, and go find a better job. Maybe look into getting into the Thieves Guild. Nope, didn't mean to steal. Sorry. That's how stealing works, you just click. You may get money, you may not get money. Pawn shop. That's useful. Much better. And it's probably across the city. Yep. Well, shake a leg. Is that it? Yes. Hello there. Take my stuff. That should give us, after haggling, yeah, that's good. Should be enough to buy a horse. Which they don't have. Do they have anything else? I need better weapons. They do got iron pants. Yeah, nothing else. Let's go find a general store now. Somewhere north. Well, that's marked. That's good enough for me. There, that small dot next to the inn. Actually, now that I'm near, I might as well see if I could start my initiation quest for the Thieves Guild. There's probably something to steal in the palace. Usually is. Gotta find a box. No, that's not. That's not the one. Ah, yes. Not the most expensive things, but will do. Well, I didn't mean to equip it, but here. I can feel the game slowing down. It has probably spawned several guards now. Ah, paintings! These should be valuable. Now let's see. Hope I can get out.
Hold!
Yep, the game's chugging.
Hold!
It's not my computer. That's just how DOSBox is. Alright, let's dance.
Hold!
Oh, stuck. And right past you.
Hold!
And I made it. Nice. And that's how you steal stuff. You just go in, take whatever you want, and hope you can get out. Actually, I think I can sell this on here. Yeah, take my stolen loot. I mean, totally legit stuff I pilfered from the dungeons. Have a nice day. Now for the horse. Hopefully we have more than enough to buy one. Right here, this small hut. I'm gonna buy myself a horse. And I get a good deal. Excellent. Maybe you want these paintings that I have. Oh, well, take these clothes. Alright. Finally! Now we're off to a good start. Now that I think about it, I might get a better weapon. Let's see. If there's any good daggers I can use. Was that a... Not daggers, I could also use sword as well. I think here was the best possible option. The Wakashashi. I mean, I think that's a sword. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Say, you wouldn't happen to have any quests for me. Well, tough luck. Much better. I'm not gonna go back to the dungeon. I'm just gonna find more opportunities. The libraries. Southeast. Yeah, I think that's the library. so much better. Broker, which was actually closer to the gate. A bit closer. Knights of the Dragon, Guild Hall. Find the librarian. This guy. Assassins have threatened to kill me tonight because I have refused to sell my land. Well, sounds like a tough job, but why not? I'll take my chances. 3 hours before midnight. Got it. Now where's the exit? Garrismith residence. Got it on the map. I think the game is bugging out a bit. Every time I click an option, I would hear the horse. What's the term? Whine? The horse makes a sound. Should take the menu back for a bit. Check the time. Alright, he said 3 hours before midnight, so let's loiter. Just in case I miss the deadline. Alright. Place a lot. Doors are locked. That's the exit. There's two exits. And here's our guy. Right? I'll be your guardian angel. Don't worry, I just bought a new weapon. Oh wait, maybe I need... I may have made a mistake, maybe I need to talk to him. Nope. Ah! Here they come. This is not your problem, stranger. Leave Masterson to us. I'm sorry, but I'm getting paid. I'll take you down. Eat my Japanese weapon. The AI is confused. Ha! Did it. The victor goes to spoils. Can I wear this? Yes, I can. Looking mighty spiffy. Yep, no problem. Oh god, what? Oh. Oh, what the hell was that? Poison weapons? That was weird. Oh, now I gotta do it again. No problem. It's probably as easy as it is in the second time. The guy's not here yet. There he is now. Yeah, I saw that too. Which is why I think maybe it's some kind of poison weapon. Are they here? Maybe I need to trigger it. What time is it? Ah. Not yet. Here they come. Just like last time. Up. Nice. Not a problem at all. But can I loot the other guy? Here. Can I wear this? No. Oh. Stuff's getting too heavy. Well, that was easier. And I didn't even get hit. Yeah, must have been some kind of weapon. So, where do next? It's light. I should probably head to the inn. I'll rest up a bit for next day and look for another quest. I think it's about time also that the main quest would trigger. Yep, good enough. I need a room for one day. Nine hours sounds good. Okay, now we need to get rid of this stuff that we just picked up. Just some random rooms. Oh, right. I mean, upstairs. Much better. Apparently I was looking for the back door. Quality bear house. They might take my stuff. You care about the quality? Then look at this stuff. Maybe he has something I could use. I still have the gold bars. A lot of junk if you ask me. Saber. Do you have a job? No. I should actually check my inventory just to be sure. No. Okay, there's stores in the east. Library, Adventurous, Bijouterie. Is that French? Paintings, do you buy them? No, you don't. I think I did sell this guy my stolen items. Or maybe it was the other. Maybe it was someone else. Smithy, clothing, warehouse. There's a temple there. Pawn shop, please. Southeast, southwest. Ah, there we go. Ah, you'll buy my legit paintings and my armor too, and for very little money because our haggling skills aren't up to the task. But we got a lot of money right now. Maybe even we could buy something interesting. If the store would have something interesting, that is. No, I already have that. Alright, time to find another job. What? Unfortunate coupling. Links in the sword. Champion gemstones. That sounds good. Shut up, horse! Alright, that was in the south. Oh yeah, I think I passed that. No wait, actually, that's the same place I had the other quest. Is there a new quest now, or...? No, that's Mordester's jewelry. Nah, I've gone wrong direction. West. Is it giving me the wrong place? Give me some of the work. Champion gemstones. Okay, this should help me. Yeah, I don't see it. Yeah, no. How about those pups? That was an unfortunate goblin. Now, there it is. Huh. It doesn't actually show up on the right color. That's interesting. It seems to be the part of the other jewelry store. Okay. My friend is missing. Sure. But all the Wickwing must not be seen for 4 days. Worried? consorted with Morista Kingfield and Kalorala Ashhouse. 2 days. Okay. This is gonna be an easy quest. To ask from people. So this is the person we are looking for. No wait, that's no wait, it's not. It's the God damn, this horse won't shut up! Low Tristrian supply. Northwest. Alright. Reaching into your pack for something to eat, you spy a note. Oh! I think this means... I heard about your ex- yeah, this is the main quest. But it's somehow... Yeah, this is not right. Savage Hedgehog Investment. Okay, good. I'll get to it as soon as I finish this one. Still a long way to go. At least we're on horse right now. Thankfully I don't have to worry about running over people. Or dodging obstacles. Park right here, and let's see. It's probably not this guy. Usually when you go to stores in order to look for some NPC, they usually seem to spawn here. No, I haven't seen her for a couple of days. Try asking Perival Woodcroft. And our hunt continues. Now, he's probably at the other side of the town. Failed check. Again. Woodcroft residence. Somewhere south. Excuse me, Woodcroft residence? No, not the palace. Oh, it's not here. Well, people then. That helps. And there's a location. So there should be a person in here who knows about the missing person. Maybe. Even the damn buildings are labyrinths. Gotta get up. Let's see, can I'm sure you can use the ladder somehow. Nice. Told you I might know. Afraid not. All I know is drinking last night. Well, that was a waste of time. I'm gonna take your gold. And other stuff. Including your potion of healing. Yeah, that's gonna be useful. Now let's see, hopefully I can avoid any guards that have spawned. Although I'm not hearing anything. Okay, that was a dead end, but there's still the other guy. Carolara. Agrivir's Quality Warehouse, Northeast. Now that I think about it, this is probably not the most interesting stream because of all the randomization and the very simplicity of these quests. Christine Masterson will be livid. Okay, that's it. I think that's it. That is not much that interesting to look at. Come on, tell me things. Let's go back to the champion gemstones. Try other Elder Scrolls games. I'm definitely much more interested in playing like the Morrowind. Not sure about Skyrim. Skyrim is a bit overdone at the moment. But you know, it all depends on my mood. Alright, I've done your job. Thank you. Alright, I'm gonna do this. Do the main. This part of the main quest. What was it? Westmont. Savage Hedgehog. Westmont. Yeah, now it travels faster. And the place was called Savage Hedgehog. Well, there's only one inn. So that narrows it down. Responding my letter, I am Lady Prisciana. Let me bring you the date on the affairs. Spectre of King Lysander haunts the streets of Daggerfall at night, trying to communicate with him is futile. He will occasionally moan the word vengeance. We should actually check that out. Probably more gainful to investigate those who might have wronged Lysander. So she recommends that I should talk to the kings and queens and princes, whatever, of the major powers, the Sentinel, Bayrest, and Daggerfall. Doesn't know about the letter, really. Not really helpful, but it helps kick off the main quest. Now let's go visit Daggerfall. I'm gonna save. Because this will probably not end, might not end well. Recklessly, so we arrive at night. So, Alright, he should be around here. Let's climb over the wall. Oh! Damn it! I had to pick my spots better. Now I'm stuck. This should work better. Oh! Something shot at me. Well, doesn't matter. We got made in. I gotta be careful with this. Nice. Now, the ghost should be around here somewhere. You'll know. Actually, now that I think about it, it might be too late. Yeah, let's go sleep. Room for one day. Hours. Let's start with that. And now 4 hours. And he should be here now. Yep, that's him. No, wait, that's not him. That's a different ghost. And that's something else. Oh! He's here. Hold on. Let's try that again. They're still chasing me. Yep. This is not how I want it to go. I don't know why the guards are chasing me.
Vengeance!
The ghost is here! Fight the ghost if you have proper weapons, but defeating him is no use. He'll always come back.
Vengeance.
Anyway, that's about it for today. So hopefully you had fun. I don't think it's as fun as I thought it would be. Because of all the randomization, it's not really interesting to watch as it is to play. But you win some, you lose some, I guess. So thank you all for watching. Tomorrow I will probably be back with maybe another game. Probably not gonna play this. But I hope I'll see you next time.